I welcome to all in today's online education session started by our Brihanmumbai Municipal Corporation Education Department. So students, let's start the today's session. I welcome to again in the online education standards 6 YouTube channel. Today's subject is English. Myself Ravindra Pawar from Mulund Camp English Municipal Upper Primary School. Before starting the today's lesson, students, I want to ask you some riddles. You have to guess what is the answer and raise your hands to give the answer. Okay. The first riddle is in front of you. I am going to read the riddle. You have to think and guess. Okay. So I am in the sky. I am white. I am round but not always. Sometimes you see me. Sometimes you don't. Who am I? Who will tell the answer?
Sir, Moon.
Moon. Excellent. Excellent answer. So, the riddle describes the moon. Here, another riddle is here. So, I am going to read. You have to guess and give the answer. The second riddle is, I sleep by day, I fly by night. I sleep by day, I fly by night. I have no feathers to aid my flight. Who am I? What is the answer of this riddle? Who will tell?
Bad.
Who will tell? See the riddle first. I sleep by day, I fly by night. I have no feathers to aid my flight.
Chamgadar.
Yes, another. Anyone else? Guess, think, and then give the answer. Who sleeps by day? Who fly by night? I have no feathers to read my
sir. Sir, moon, because moon come at night.
Very good, very good, excellent. So here, the second moon answer sir. Is the so students. We've seen here the both the results described about the moon. Okay, so in the same way, in our textbook there is one poem. In that poem, the poet describes the moon in a good manner, in a very beautiful manner. So that poem name is The Silver House. So students, today we are going to learn the poem. The name is The Silver House, the unit 2 and the chapter number 5, The Silver House. So students, let's start the today's poem. So here, the poet John Lee described the moon as a silver house. You can see here the moon in the silver color. So the main point is that, main concept is that the poet John Lee describes the moon as a silver house. Okay, so let's start what is given in the poem. First of all, I am going to read the poem. You have to listen carefully. Okay. There's a silver house in the lovely sky, as round as a silver crown. It takes 2 weeks to build it up and 2 to pull it down. There's a man who lives in the silver house in a lonely sort of way. But what this name is, no one knows or no one likes to say. 8. When you go to bed tonight, just draw the window blind and peep out at the silver moon, this lonely man to find. But if his house is taken down and all the sky is bare, then go to bed, because of course the poor man won't be there. Okay, students, I hope you listen the poem carefully. There are total 4 stanzas in the poem, and what the poet is going to describe, we will see one by one. Okay, we will see stanza wise. Okay, look at the next slide. So there is the first stanza. There is a silver house in the lovely sky, as round as a silver crown. So here, student, the poet is going to describe moon as a silver house and describes the sky in a beautiful way. Lovely sky means what? Very beautiful, very beautiful. We always like to see the sky in the night. Yes or no? Everyone likes to see the sky in the night, because at the time of night, the sky seems very beautiful. So poet describes here that there is a silver house. The silver house means there is a moon. So you can see in the picture also, the moon is looking very beautiful and its color is silver. You know the metal silver, gold, and you also know the color of that silver. We also use the ornaments of the silver. Okay, it looks very nice or very bright. So here moon is also looking very brightly in silver color, and as round as the silver crown. Here the poet describes or compares the moon to the crown. So here crown means what, students? Here crown means what? Not the ornament that use the prince, kings. Here crown means what? An old British silver coin that was used in the England in the past. So we know that, or we learn in the history, in the past there was the coins of the metals, for example silver, gold, copper. Yes or no? And instead of the coins of the today, jo coins we use rupees, at that time there was the coins of the metals like silver, gold, copper. So here, and the you all of you know that the coin has a circular shape, and if you observe carefully, the moon is also in the round shape. So that's why the poet says that as round as a silver crown. Here poet also give use the one figure of speech that we call the simile, because here word is came as round as. So if any word is compared to the other with the help of word as, that figures of speech we call simile. So here one there is a one phrase, student. A silver house in the lovely sky. It is a phrase. Phrase means what? It has a certain meaning, or group of words that has a certain meaning. Here, what is the meaning of first line? It means the there is a silver moon in the sky. Okay, nothing but the silver moon. Silver house means nothing but the silver moon. And the next line, the poet is going to describe that it takes 2 weeks to build it up. Means what? So it takes to build the 2 weeks. 2 weeks means 15 days. You all know there are the 30 days in the month, and if you divide in two parts, the 2 weeks means 15 days and another 2 weeks means 15 days. So here two phrases are also came, to build it up and to pull it down. So here also the group of words, and the meaning is what? The both the meaning, to build it up and to pull it down, describes the phases of the moon. Now, student, tell me, any one of you, do you know about anything about the phases of the moon? Just raise your hand if you know about something, phases of the moon. Can you tell? Can you say something that you know? Anything, as 1 point, 2 point, that you know about the phases of the moon?
Third quarter, vernal, crescent, new moon, waning.
Yes, very good. So here, look at the screen, student. The one picture is there about the phases of the moon. So here, in the first line, what the poet is going to say? The poet is going to say that it takes 2 weeks to build it up. Means what? The 2 weeks during which the moon grows bigger, or it takes total 15 days from new moon to full moon, and that is also called the waxing of the moon. Here we can see here, so from the new moon, first it comes in the waxing crescent phase, next it comes first quarter, next it goes bigger and comes in the waxing globus phase, and at last in the full moon night it becomes the circular and round. Hence here poet is describes that it takes 2 weeks to build it up. Okay, 2 weeks means 15 days. And in the next line, the second phrase is there, pull it down. So what is means pull it down? So after the full moon night, it starts the pull it down, means slowly moves, decreasing their shape. And first he goes to waning gibbous mode. Next he decreases and his shape, and goes in the phase of third quarter. After that, waning crescent, and at last from full moon to new moon. New moon means what? No moon is there. We can't see the moon in new moon night. Yes. So here, to pull it down means what? The 2 weeks during which the moon keeps decreasing in size, and it takes 15 days. 2 weeks means what? 15 days. And that from the full moon to new moon, full moon night to new moon night. And that process is also called the waning of the moon. So in this way, here in the two lines, the poet describes the phases of the moon. Okay. In the geography, you can also learn in detail about the phases of the moon. Yes or no? You get the lot of information or detailed information in geography about the topic phases of the moon. Okay. Whenever you got the time, you can just go through the geography textbook, and you can find out the lot of information, or otherwise you can also search on the internet also. Okay. So you will got the detailed information about the phases of the moon. So here poet describes the phases of the moon. Okay. So I hope you understood. So now tell me, student, which are the two adjectives are used here in the first two lines to describe the moon? Who will tell? Two adjectives are given here in the first two lines. Which are they? Which describes the moon? Student, just raise your hand. two adjectives are came here. Yes. Hello. Yes. Want to say? Okay. Let me tell.
Sir, silver house and silver crown.
Yes, silver house and silver crown, or round as silver crown. Yes, there are the two adjectives. Yes or no? It describes the noun. So very good, beta. There are silver house, silver crown, or round in the silver crown. Those are the adjectives. Very good. And my next question is, tell me, how much time does the house, silver house, take to build it up or to pull it down? How much time it take? It takes 2 weeks. Okay, 2 weeks to build it up means 15 days to build it up, or 2 weeks to pull it down. Okay, so let's move for the students. Next stanza, the second stanza is there. There's a man who lives in the silver house in a lonely sort of way, but what his name is, no one knows or no one likes to see. So in the second stanza, the poet is going to describe that there is a man who lives in the silver house. The poet is going to imagine, this is the imagination of the poet. When we observe the moon carefully, we can see the different figures on the surface of the moon, and poet sees there and says that there is a man who lives in the silver house. In the silver house means on the moon. Or he looks very lonely. Lonely sort of way means what? Someone who is lonely or unhappy. Because why he is unhappy or lonely? Because no one is there to play with him or to talk with him. That's why he feeling lonely. Okay. And but what his name is, no one knows. So what is said that what? No one knows his name because no one is there on the moon to know his name. Yes, we are here. We are on the earth. So we can't say his name. So no one is ready to say his name because they don't know the name of the man. Okay. So look at the next slide. There is a third stanza. In what the poet is describing that. Eight, when you go to bed tonight, just draw the window blind and peep out at the silver moon, this lonely man to find. So before starting the explanation about this stanza, I want to ask you to question upon the second stanza. Now tell me, who lives in the silver house? Who will tell?
Man is a silver house.
Yes, a lonely man. A lonely man lives in the silver house. Excellent answer. And my second question is, tell me, what is the name of the man who lives in the silver house?
No one likes to say.
Yes, yes. No one knows the name of the man. That's why we can't say the name of the man. Very good. So let's start third stanza. Here, going to next, the poet is giving one task to you. To you means what? To us. Because we are reading this poem now. Yes or no? So it gives, a poet gives one task to us that you can see here, the boy is observing the moon from his window. One girl is also observing or seeing the window from his moon from his window. So here, eight when you go to bed tonight. So what the poet is going to ask you to just open the window shade. Window shade means what? To open the window covering that has everyone's window. Yes or no? And just draw means what? To move to one side. Just remove the covering of the window. Here the meaning of window blind is protective cover for a window that everyone has. So poet asks you that before go to bed means before go to sleep today night tonight, just open your window, just remove the shade cover of the your window. And what we have to do? What is the task the poet give here? The poet asks you and peep out at the silver moon. Peep out means what? Just look quickly or secretly from your window at the silver moon. You have to observe the silver moon, look carefully to the silver moon, and you have to find the lonely man. Okay, the man in the silver moon. So you try to find the man who is lives in the silver house. If is there a man, if you find, so you have to try just before you go to bed, means you go to sleep. So one task gives us by the poet to observe the moon and to find out the man. So now students, here we can observe the moon only when there is a full moon night. Yes or no? At that time only you can observe the moon in round shape and different figures or different shapes or man in the moon. Okay. So now tell me which tasks the poet gives us in this stanza. What is the poet is going to ask us here?
Sir,
yes.
Just draw the window blind.
Yes, you just draw the window blind. Just remove the cover of your window. And what you have to do? What work? What task? Yes.
And observe the moon in the full moon day.
Yes, yes. Very exactly. So just observe the silver moon and try to find out the lonely man. Very good, beta. So let's move further. The fourth and the last stanza. Okay. So, but if his house is taken down and all the sky is bare, then go to bed because, of course, the poor man won't be there. So students, next to the third stanza, we learn that in the third stanza, poet gives us the one task to find out the lonely man. But what the poet is going to describe here, the poet is want to describe or gives us one suggestion. But if his house is taken down, so here you can see the one picture. The picture is about the new moon night. New moon night means what? We can't see the moon there. Okay. So, but if his house is taken down, here is also one phrase. Taken down means what? Pull down. Or pull down means we already learned the phases of the moon. The time that moon is in the new moon night, there is the no moon in the sky. Okay. And all the sky is bare. So bare means what? Here the poet is going to say that sky is bare means the moonless sky. We can't see the moon there. That's why the poet is going to say that if his house is taken down, if there is a new moon night, there is no moon in the sky, and sky is looking lonely and moonless, so then what we have to do? So at that time, there is no need to find the man in the silver house. So you have to go to bed. You have to go to sleep. You don't observe the sky. Because of course, why? So it is already know, we know that if there is no moon, so we can't observe the man. Yes or no? So that's why if the no moon is there, so we can't find the poor man in the silver house. The poor man won't be there. Okay. If moon is not there, so how it is possible to observe the man in the moon? That's why the poet is going to say that in the new moon night, you don't go to the observe the moon. You just go to sleep. Okay. Here also one phrase we discussed, taken down means pulled down. Okay. So in this way, the poet describes the moon in the very beautiful manner. And it describes the moon also sky in a beautiful way. So there's one question for you. So tell me, what will happen if you try to find out the moon in the new moon night? What will happen if you try to find the moon, lonely man in the new moon night? Who will say the answer? Okay, let me say. If we try to find the moon,
sir,
or man in the silver house.
Sir, because
yes.
The moon is new moon is poor and full moon is the silver.
Yes. Okay. So what will happen? So we can't see the man because there is no moon. Okay. Already there is no moon in the night, so we can't find out the poor man. Okay. So in this way we learn the four stanzas, the poem by John Lee, The Silver House. So student, it's time to recall what we have to, what we learn. So just recall in short. So there was four stanzas in the poem, and four the stanzas describes the different way. In the first, we saw that the poet John Lee describes the moon as silver house in the beautiful sky. And next to that, the poet is say that it takes 2 weeks to build it up and 2 weeks to pull it down. Here, the poet describes the phases of the moon. Okay. Or it takes total 15 days to new moon to full moon night. And also takes the 15 days from full moon to new moon night. In the second stanza, we learn that the poet says that there is a man who lives in the silver house. Poet imagines that there is a one man and he is very lonely in the silver house. Because of he is alone, no one knows his name and nobody ready to see. Say his name. In the third stanza, we learn that the poet asks you to open the window. Poet gives you one task that open the window and just look at the silver house. Silver house means nothing but the silver moon. So we have to just look at the silver moon and try to find this lonely man at night. But when when there is a full moon night. Okay, when there is the moon in the round shape, at that time only you can find the lonely man. And the last stanza, finally the poet tells you that if there is a moonless night, means new moon night, so you should go to sleep. You don't go to observe the moon through the window. You should go to sleep as the lonely man no longer there in the silver house. Because of the new moon night, you can't observe the moon, that is silver house. And if there is a no silver house, there is a no poor man. So in this way, the poet describes the poem very well, in good manner. So students, it's time to yourself. It's time of the assignment. You have to do some practice of the questions. Look at the screen. There are two questions. It will develop your thinking. It will help to develop your thinking. And we have to do the homework very sincerely. The first question is there. Find out at least 5 poems written on the moon with the help of internet. What we have to do? Just go through the internet. You can search on the Google the poems on the moon. So you will find the lot of poems written on the moon. So small poems, 3 stanzas, 2 stanzas, 4 stanzas, you have to collect, or you have to write down in your notebook, okay, or make a collection of 5 poems, okay. And the second is, write a poem on at least one of the following topic by your own. So what we have to do here, you have to try, you have to think, to write a simple poem in a simple language. No need to use a hard language. You have to use the simple rhyming words, and you have to try to write a simple poem on moon, river, flower, tree, or another any topic. If you want to write on another topic apart from them, so you can also write. So just think like a poet, and try to use the rhyming words and write the simple poem. Simple, in a simple way. 2 lines, 3, 4 lines, 6 lines. So you have to write down the poem. So students, I hope you understood the poem. So thank you very much. If you have any doubts, so you can ask me. Raise your hand and ask me any doubts if you are having.
No, sir, no doubt.
Okay, okay. So students, in this way we learn an interesting poem. The name was The Silver House. We will see you, meet again in the next session. Before that, I would like to say, in this condition, the main thing is to protect yourself from coronavirus. You have to wash your hands again and again. You have to wear the mask whenever you go outside the home. Do the regular exercise and concentrate on your study. For more information, for more videos regarding your topic, subjects, you can also go through the YouTube channel, that is BMC Edu English Standard 6. And you can find the videos, interesting videos, and it will definitely help you to improve your knowledge. Okay, students, see you in the next session. Thank you very much. Have a nice day.